Good morning, everybody. I look a little silly, but today is our Harvest Fest, so most of us are in costume today, and you're gonna see that when we go in. Today we start a new unit, which is all about Solomon, and this time the potters will be teaching, so enjoy this.
As everybody stands up and gets ready for worship, I wanna say hello to all of you joining us on Facebook Live. We are happy you're joining us this morning. If you're wearing a costume at home to celebrate our Harvest Fest, let us know by sending us a comment. And we're gonna get started with some worship this morning. Our first song this morning is called Whoa. For those of you who may remember that song, it's the song that looks like a comic book in the video. If you can do this, like We Will Rock You, you pretty much have this song down, all right? So there are some motions during the chorus, but you'll catch on to those pretty quickly. Ms. Dory, hit it.
Sing out loud, you can sing this song. Everybody join me in praising the King and singing whoa.
Good job, everybody. All right, now I think you guys are awake. We had a pretty good crowd here this morning, too. Yeah, that's awesome.
Look at all those fun costumes.
I know, those are amazing. I'm especially liking, I gotta point out my man King George over here. Very good. My friend who is in the process of being abducted by an alien.
But look, we have an astronaut going to rescue him, I think.
Oh, that's awesome! Yes! Fantastic. Well
done.
We're
going to have to get a picture of those two together.
Yes, we do. That's good. That looks like a quality jetpack there, capable of catching him. That's good. All right. Our second song this morning is called Bubbling Up. We sang this song for the first time a few years ago for K2 Kaboom. So our fourth and fifth graders, you guys might remember this one. First and second grade, this might be new to you guys. The song talks about there's something kind of stirring up inside, and that is the Spirit of God. That is the Holy Spirit talking to us, telling us, guiding us in what we should do in our lives. And that's what we're talking about this morning when we talk about bubbling up, all right? Let's do it, Ms. Dory.
There's something moving in my heart, something stirring. My soul, something welling up inside, something so incredible. There's something I cannot explain, something only God could do, something I cannot contain, something beautiful and new. It's bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, up to the surface. Bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up,
to sing all that through one more time.
There's something moving in my heart, something stirring in my soul, something welling up inside, something so incredible. There's something I cannot explain, something only God can do, something I cannot contain, something beautiful and new. It's bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, up to the surface. Bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, up to the surface.
I'm gonna hear you guys sing.
And I can't keep it in.
Turn in a circle, ready?
Good job, everybody. All right.
Team.
You guys can go ahead and have a seat. We're going to welcome up Scarecrow Pastor Dave to pray for us before we get into the large group lesson.
Okay, I am so glad all of you are here today, and God is even more glad. How many of you are excited to get a treat bag after this to go out and get treats? How many of you are excited? All right. Looks like six or seven of you. That's twice as many as the first service. I'm so glad you're here. Look around at all of our leaders. Look at your leaders. And isn't it amazing how God provides people to serve, who love us, to serve us, and to know that we can have people teach us God's word? Isn't that amazing? And we are so grateful for all of our leaders. We're grateful for God that He gives us this place to serve. We're grateful for all of our people online. We're waving to you. Everybody put your hands up and wave, even though they can't see you. They can see me. We're all waving at you, people online. We're grateful that you're here. And we're going to pray now and ask God to bless our time together. One, two, three. Lord, you are so good. We thank you that you love us, that you sent Jesus to take away our sins, that we can have life with you forever and ever. And we thank you for the fun that we're going to have today as we celebrate birthdays and we celebrate the time of the year when we bring in the harvest. And you said, look around. The harvest is ready now. People are ready to receive Jesus. And so we pray that you'll help us to receive you and obey you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Dave. All right, well, good morning, everybody. We are so glad that you are here. We'll be coming around to small groups at the end of your small group to give you your bags and your special cakes for birthdays today, and then you guys can leave from here and head out to the Harvest Fest stuff is going to be out in the front and out the other doors of the atrium in the worship center. Oh, no, all out front? Oh, sorry, did not get that message. It's all out front. Okay, don't go that way. You'll miss the candy. Go this way. All right. Okay, as you see, the stage changed. So we've got a new unit starting today, and we've got special guests that are going to be here for the next few weeks. We love them if you know them. So I want you guys to pay attention to the video first and then give all your attention to the Potter family after.
David was old. He had been the king of Israel for many years. And now his son Solomon was going to be king. God had promised David that Israel's king would always be someone from his family. Before David died, he gave Solomon some instructions. Be strong and brave, Solomon, David said. Obey God and you will be successful. God will keep his promise that every king of Israel will come from our family. When David died, Solomon became the king of Israel. One night, God appeared to Solomon in a dream. God said, "Solomon, ask for anything you want, and I will give it to you." Anything? A king might have asked to live a long life or to have lots of riches. Solomon could have asked God to give him victory over all his enemies. But Solomon did not ask to be rich or to have a long life. Solomon wanted to be a good king. He asked for something even better. Solomon prayed, "God, I am young, and I do not know very much about being a king. Please make me wise and obedient to you. Help me know the difference between right and wrong. Help me lead your people well." God was happy with Solomon's request. God said, "I will give you wisdom. In fact, I will make you more wise and understanding than anyone who has ever lived. No one in the future will ever be as wise as Solomon." Then God said, "Because you asked for wisdom, I will also give you what you did not ask for. Long life, riches, and honor. You will be greater than any other king during your lifetime." Solomon woke up and realized God had spoken to him in a dream. Solomon praised God and offered sacrifices to worship him. Solomon was a wise king who wanted to do God's plan. God planned to give his people a greater and wiser king, his son, Jesus. Jesus completely trusted God with his life. Jesus surrendered his own life to die on the cross for our sin.
All right, guys. Yes. I knew you were wondering, why are we down at the port with the docks and the boats and everything?
Yes.
Are we gonna go fishing?
No, no. We had so much fun on the train this summer.
Yes.
I thought, you know what? The next step is a boat.
A boat.
Ooh. Yes.
Yes.
So
yes.
Now I don't know if you have your sea legs.
Okay, I see my legs.
No, sea legs.
Sea legs.
Because the boat goes this way.
What?
And then it goes this way.
Oh, wait.
And then it goes this way.
Wait.
So we have to get on the boat.
Sick.
We have to get on the boat.
Oh.
Okay. On the boat. Oh, yes.
Wait,
it's a little wobbly.
Little wobbly.
I'm going to have to need a little help here.
See, that's why you kind of crouch a little bit. Then you don't fall over. It's great. Little wobbly boat. See?
Oh.
It's a boat. Yes.
I don't think I'm that good a sailor.
Oh, okay. We got this.
Okay.
Because.
Why? What?
Not only are we on a boat.
We are on a boat.
But we're on the iBoat 400.
Anything you put an I in front of makes it really cool.
It is amazing. Yes. Look at all these instructions.
Who reads instructions? Oh. You guys don't read instructions.
Well, nobody reads instructions.
Okay, but that was the manual. It's kind of.
We don't need it.
All righty. Well, apparently, this entire boat is controlled with this keyboard.
Ooh.
Yes. So you can put
it. Look at all the buttons.
No, you don't touch.
Oh, I want to touch a button.
No. Okay. I am the sub captain, but. Because this is the iBoat 400.
iBoat.
It sails itself.
Ooh.
Whoa, what?
Yeah. Yes.
It sails itself.
All you have to do is put in where you want to go.
Oh.
Where you want to go.
And it goes there.
Ooh.
So we could say we want to go to the Caribbean.
I want to go to the Caribbean.
Yes.
Caribbean.
We will go somewhere much easier to spell.
Yes.
What is easier to spell?
Easier to spell.
Hawaii!
I can do Hawaii.
I can spell Hawaii.
Ha, ha.
W.
Anyone.
Y. H.
I
Okay. Q.
The Q is silent. The Q is silent.
It's always silent.
Q.
Okay. You know what?
Okay, but you know what?
I'm confused.
That's beside the fact.
Why are we on this boat?
Oh, yes. Yeah. We actually have a job.
Oh, a job.
We are taking supplies to a fall festival.
Fall festival, which
look at the time. Oh, we gotta get started. We need to get all the supplies onto the boat.
Oh, so
we
boat.
We're gonna put them.
We have to put them on the boat.
Yes. Well, it's just the three of us.
Oh, that's the boat.
Okay.
I'm gonna put that there. We need to get that.
I'm gonna put this here because we might need it. What are we loading here?
We are loading popcorn, candy.
You get the candy.
And props.
I get the candy.
Don't eat it.
No, wait.
Don't eat it.
That's pretty heavy there.
Hey! You look like you need more. They're so weak. I work out. Watch this.
I got a leg in my mouth.
If I push,
just get it there.
Wait.
Oh my God.
Lift with your back or your legs.
I tell you what.
Back.
I'm going to put this.
Oh no. Stop the back.
We're going to put it right here.
Okay, watch out.
I'm putting it right.
Watch out. Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Oh!
Sorry.
What?
Okay.
You're dangerous.
Oh. That's hot.
Oh, hot.
Well, because. I didn't forget to warn you. This is the iBoat 400 engine. It's a dual capacity something.
It runs hot. Shouldn't we not put like the candy next to something hot?
I think it'd be fine.
I'm not sure.
There's not enough room otherwise.
It's out of the way. Yeah. It's out of the way.
Okay.
You know what? I'll move it away from the hot side.
There. It'll be fine.
But wait, no, wait.
Your candy's delicious.
It says,
yes.
It's fine.
Awesome.
Move it. It'll be fine.
It'll be because they're so silly.
Oh my goodness.
All right. I am going to put in now our destination.
Can I press that button?
No pressing.
No, it says cannon. We can shoot those children over there.
Ooh.
You shoot the children?
The cannon button.
Should we do the cannon button? That would be super smart.
Okay. All right, I'm going to put in Florida because that's where
Florida.
We're going.
FLORIDA. Yes.
Enter.
Yes. It's moving.
Whoa, right up. It's going.
Whoa, yeah.
All right.
Great.
We're
sailing the ocean blue.
Ooh.
It's wonderful.
You know, actually, it's a little boring.
Wait, look! There's water over there!
And water there!
It's just a lot of water.
Got a lot of water here.
Really?
Okay.
How are we going to entertain ourselves?
Wait. Let's see. Ba-ba! There's no Wi-Fi. It doesn't work!
I don't have
a device. I can't think. There's nothing to do now.
We can't play Among Us.
That's
the world.
Okay,
no,
I got this.
Screen. Falling apart.
Oh, no.
There's no iPads, no phones.
Oh, no.
We're doomed, children.
Forever.
What is that?
These are props. Look at
these. Props.
It was in the box. It said props.
I know what these are.
What are these?
These are the photo booths where you look all crazy.
Oh.
That is amazing.
You know, I never look crazy. I look good.
I always look good.
Oh, look at this.
I always look good.
It's Yoda dinosaur.
I just dropped the hat in the ocean.
Look, I'm
that's
baby
all right, though.
Yoda dinosaur.
Oh, look.
With claw hand.
Oh.
You know, we got to take a picture.
Yes. Oh, pictures are awesome.
Okay, wait, selfie it. Wait, if we...
Okay, hold on, because I need to be in it.
This way.
Oh, no. Oh, my goodness.
Hold on.
Okay.
Wait.
Get it.
No, you're going the wrong way. This way.
What? How are we going to get them?
Here.
The floating way.
Here. Reach. Reach and get it.
Don't
reach.
Let me go.
Come on. Reach. Get it. You can. No.
Okay.
Oh.
Water in October is cold.
Oh. What? What are we going to do with this?
You know what? Oh. Kids don't like dressing up in funny things.
No.
Maybe they won't notice.
Yes. Maybe they won't.
They won't notice.
It'll be fine.
It'll be great.
Wonderful. What are we going to do?
Did someone put on a new perfume that's a very odd campfire-y smell?
I am smelling something like slightly burning.
Burn. What is burning?
What is that?
What is that burning?
I don't.
What? The popcorn's popping!
Okay. Eat it! Eat it!
Stop it!
Okay. Stop! Move it away!
Did you know popcorn when it gets hot? Pop!
Oh my goodness!
That's insane!
What are we gonna do now?
Oh no!
What?
What?
If the popcorn popped when it got hot.
Yes.
What happened to the candy?
Oh no!
Oh no! Oh no! Let's see. Oh my goodness. Uh-oh. Oh my goodness.
Oh no.
Kids like to eat this, surely?
Oh my goodness.
Ew. Oh no.
And then it doesn't come off.
The parents love this part.
It's not coming off. It's
then you just
stuck on me.
Wipe it now on your mother's favorite sofa.
Oh my goodness, that's awful.
Wait, what are we gonna do? We have nothing.
We have nothing to deliver.
Kids don't like candy.
Okay, wait. Surely there is something on this boat we can give to them.
Okay.
Something we can give. Something we can give.
I see something. The most coveted thing in 2020. Children love toilet paper.
There we go.
Yes!
Here.
Yes!
I have a juice box.
One juice box.
And a box of cereal. Oh, Everyone can have one Cheerio.
Yes!
I found a slinky!
Yes!
I would love. And you know what we can do?
We can poke a hole in the juice box so they can open their mouths and we can just squirt it in.
Yes.
It would be a great fun.
That's a fun game.
Yes.
Guys.
Oh, yes.
I think we have a problem. I think we made some unwise choices.
We may have ruined
the fall festival.
Oh, it's terrible.
You could have read the directions and made wise choices, but
how do you know how to make a wise choice? Wait a minute!
Wait! You know what?
You know what?
What? Making wise choices?
That reminds me!
That reminds me!
Hey, that reminds me!
Of a Bible story!
Oh, boys and girls, what a mess you can get into when you go by what you think is right, and it turns out to be so wrong. So today we're going to learn how one man made some really wise choices. But before we begin, we got to get our minds back. So let's put our hands together, put your lips together, and close your eyes so we can talk to God. Oh, Father in heaven, thank you, God, that you're here with us. And thank you that these boys and girls came today. And Lord, I pray that the boys and girls online can listen too. Help them to sit still, to open their hearts and their souls and their ears and their minds, to hear the story that you have for them. And Lord, I pray that you'd be with any child that couldn't make it today, that you would bring them up and get them back next week. And Lord, give me through the Holy Spirit the words I need for the story for the children today. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Now, boys and girls, In our story, you have been learning about an extraordinary man. And this man has been told to you for weeks now, and the man you've been studying, his name was David. Who can tell me what David did that was so extraordinary when he was just a boy? Yes, he did. Do you know that David, a young man, a young boy, was able to defeat a 10-foot giant? Yes. How was he able to do that? That's right. Now, listen to this. God had a special place in his heart for each of us. He gives us all abilities to do a task that God has made you to do. God made David to do a special thing for him. But the thing is, David had to figure out how to talk to God and how to listen and to figure out what God wanted. So, when David was a very young boy, you remember he was a shepherd person. He kept the sheep out on the hillsides. And we, you know, you got a lot to think about when you're out on the hillside. Got much nothing to do but watch sheep. So while he was out there, he had a harp and he began to sing. And he began to talk to God, and God saw that David loved him. David loved God with his whole heart. And then David, when he got to be a man, he was became king of Israel. And he did the right thing as far as God was concerned, because he obeyed the commandments, he kept the laws, and he did what God wanted him to do. Not always, but most of the time. And in this process, he had a son, and the son's name was Solomon. And Solomon grew up with David, the king, and David taught Solomon as they went along. But David was getting old, and he knew it was about time for him to die, and he was trying to give Solomon some wise words. And so in his last few days, David said to Solomon, "Now, Solomon, you be strong, and you be close to God. You stay close to God's heart." Said Solomon, "Obey the commandments, obey the precepts, obey God's rules for your life. And if you will do that, Solomon, God will bless you. But Solomon, if you move away from God, if you start into sin, you start disobeying, then God will move his blessing from you. So stay in tune with your God." He said, "Solomon, if you will obey God, God will keep his promises to us that his kingdom will never end. But I charge you, Solomon, obey God, love God." And Solomon, you know what? He wanted to do what his father said. So he said, "Father, this I will do." And Solomon turned out to be a wonderful king in David's place once David had passed away. And Solomon wanted what God wanted. In fact, he wanted it so much that when it came the time to sacrifice, and you remember, boys and girls, that sacrifice, they had to sacrifice. Because when you did something bad and you sinned in Old Testament times, do you know you had to take an animal, and that animal had to be presented to God as your sin offering, that you would be forgiven of your sin if you offered this animal in your place? So you would take the animal and you would put it on an altar and you would kill that animal, because blood had to be shed for the forgiveness of sins. So offerings to God were in the form of a sacrifice. Well, Solomon knew that, and he loved God so much that he went to a high place in Gibeon, and he offered not one sacrifice. Solomon offered 1,000 sacrifices to God for forgiveness of the people's sins, and so God would give him blessing. Well, after the sacrifices were over, Solomon got tired, and he was having a good sleep. But in the night, boys and girls, God spoke to Solomon, and he said, "Solomon, Solomon, ask me for anything, anything, and I will give it to you. Now, boys and girls, what do you think Solomon should ask for? Maybe what? What would be a wonderful thing to ask for if you were a king? Oh, a chariot would be good. Mm-hmm. How about money? How about a healthy body? Well, you know, I bet it was really hard for Solomon as he's thinking to himself, well, what will I ask for? And then he said, Lord God, you have been so good to my father David, and you have been so gracious to me to allow me to come to the throne to serve you, my God. And he said, but I'm young. I'm just like a child. I don't know how to rule these people. He said, God, just give me wisdom. Give me a discerning heart so that when the people come with hard things for me to decide about, I will give them the wise decision. And God, when Solomon asked for this, he said, I am so pleased because instead of asking for money and wealth, you ask for wisdom. So I will give you wisdom, and I will also give you wealth beyond your imagination and power and strength. And in a minute, we're going to learn a big decision that Solomon made, because he was like a judge sitting before hearing cases. And one day he got this very strange case. These two women came to Solomon, and they had this baby with them. And this one woman said to Solomon, oh, King Solomon, she and I were in this house alone, just the two of us, and we were both about to give birth to baby. And I had a baby son. And 3 days later, she had a baby son. But in the night, she accidentally rolled over on her baby. And when she woke up, the baby was dead. But Solomon, she was crafty. She took her dead baby and put it in my arms. And she took my live baby to her and took him away. He said, so that live baby is mine. But the other woman said, no, this live baby is mine. That dead baby is yours. And King Solomon said, wait a minute. And he thought for a minute. He said, He said, bring me a sword. So the captain of the guards brought him a sword, and he said, bring me the baby. Set it before me. So the baby was set before King Solomon. And he told the captain of the guard, take this sword. Cut this baby in two. Give half to one woman and half to the other woman. And one of the women said, no, no, please, King Solomon, do not take this baby's life. Give this baby to that woman. And the other woman said, oh, no, neither one of us will have this baby. Go ahead, cut it in two. And the soldier lifted his sword, and Solomon said, stop. I know which one is the true mother. The mother who was willing to give up her baby, that is the true mother. Take the other mother away and put her in chains for her deceit. People heard about this wise decision that Solomon had made, and it spread throughout the land, and all the people everywhere wanted to come and have Solomon give wise decisions to them on their problems. So, boys and girls, the source of our wisdom is our God, and His wisdom is in our book. We just have to learn what's in here to be wise like Solomon.
All right, can y'all say thank you to Miss Sue and her family? We're going to continue to learn about Solomon in the next few weeks, so make sure that you're here with us or joining us online so that you can hear more about Solomon's story and what we can learn from him. All right, so I'm going to get you guys up and moving. We're going to say goodbye to our online audience. Bye, everybody. Say bye.
What did Solomon ask for? Of all the things that Solomon could have asked God for, he asked for wisdom. We can learn a lot of things about Solomon, and we will look at more of them as we continue this unit.